Hey guys, JV here with a different kind of video. Today marks the actual 10th anniversary of the release of the original Mass Effect, which is quite possibly my favorite video game of all time. In honor of that, veteran animator Jonathan Cooper has shared 10 facts about the original game that I'm fairly sure nobody has heard before. I thought these were super cool and would be a lot of fun to pass along to you guys today. Also, before we get started, a little background on Cooper. He's responsible for leading animation teams on games like Mass Effect 1 and 2, Assassin's Creed 3, and most recently Uncharted 4 and Uncharted Lost Legacy. So he's an absolutely incredibly talented dude, and if you're interested in video game animation in the slightest, he is 100% worth a follow at GameAnim on Twitter. Without further ado, let's get started. The original Mass Effect marked Cooper's first mocap shoots back in 2005. The initial gameplay actions were shot and recorded in LA at Giant Studios in the Culver Studio lot, which happens to be the same soundstage that was used for Gone with the Wind. Of course, Gone with the Wind is regarded as one of the best movies of all time, so it's super cool to see Mass Effect share a venue with a film of that acclaim. It's also crazy to me how far mocap has come and that it was being used for a game that came out 10 years ago. People were dressing up in skin-tight suits with colored balls all over their bodies even back then, and it makes you wonder what the animation process will be like in 2027. This next fact has to do with one of my favorite scenes in the original game. When Shepard is grounded by the Council, Captain Anderson takes things into his own hands and punches Counselor Udina. Shane Wellborn, the cinematic lead who mo-capped Anderson, actually punched Udina's actor in the face in real life, and apparently the guy who received the punch was not too happy about that. I'm actually pretty happy though, because they produced such an iconic and memorable scene for the entire series. Perhaps it wouldn't have been as perfect if poor Udina's actor wasn't clocked in the jaw for real. Mass Effect's facial animation and customization system was absolutely groundbreaking when it first came out. The system was apparently spearheaded by a former Canadian Olympian named Ben Hindle, who won a bronze medal for bobsledding in 1999. According to Cooper, they knew they had it when they were able to recreate US President George W. Bush using the customization. I'm glad they were able to create something good, because I've always been terrible with video game character customization, even when the system is rock solid. And you know that because you're able to find a lot of incredibly looking custom characters after famous actors such as Samuel L. Jackson. There are a ton of them for even the original game. As we know, Mass Effect has a ton of conversations, so Cooper needed to find the right camera angles for this job. The system they used and stuck with throughout the series was primarily inspired by The Extras, which is a British sitcom from Ricky Gervais. The show included a ton of over-the-shoulder and uncomfortably close shots which were meant to produce awkwardly close conversations. Thankfully, that worked extremely well in Mass Effect and inspired a ton of other camera angle systems and games for years to come. When it comes to conversation systems in older games, there was a tendency to frame the characters against cool backgrounds instead of focusing on the face alone. And that was probably because the models were not interesting enough to be the center of the focus. They wanted to have something else to look at. But the 2006 E3 demo trailer for Mass Effect finally proved that the close-up conversation system would work, and that's what made it into the final product. Again, the way the original Mass Effect did things laid the groundwork for the rest of the series and so many other games that would come out over the course of the next 10 years. Since there were so many conversations in Mass Effect, the only way to ensure there was a general baseline of quality was to use procedural generation for the animation. This included facial, body, and camera work across the entire game, with cinematic designers coming in to improve them after the fact. Cooper says around 70% of scenes were retouched by hand, while 30% remained untouched and purely procedurally generated for the launch of the game. Of course, being responsible for this system, Cooper was intimately involved in the conversation around Mass Effect Andromeda's animations and what went wrong with that. The fact is, it was a very similar system, but they weren't able to retouch and get to the certain quality that you would expect for a game in 2017. In cutscenes before Mass Effect, BioWare would use black bars to create a cinematic feel in conversations. Apparently, there was an intense argument within BioWare that was finally won by those who did not want those black bars. The idea was that this would blur the line between dialogue and cutscenes, further immersing the player into the overall experience. And personally, I'm so glad they did away with black bars. In older games, it always felt a little off and like it took control away from the player and put you in a cutscene where it didn't really feel like you were the one making those decisions, which is never a good thing. So again, so happy they did this. This next fact is a bit technical, so I'll leave the entire explanation to Mr. Cooper. He says that every gameplay animation in Mass Effect had the eyes constrained forward by default to overcome the dead stare you usually found in games. This detail afforded design access to all 1,200 animations for the conversation system, applying additional eye motion on top per line as required. You can definitely notice the eye movement and how it adds that extra human element across hundreds of characters in the game. They had to find a way to do it, and this is how they did. Another super technical fact, the entire trilogy used an animation rigging tool called Puppet Shop. This was made free to the public after the original Mass Effect, but unfortunately you cannot find it anywhere at this time. Cooper claims it could have been used to make all the aliens one could think of in the entire world, but again, you can't find it now, which is probably disappointing for a lot of people. The final fact for today has to do with lip sync. Mass Effect had fully localized lip sync in all languages, which could have possibly been a first in any video game. This was because the system was procedurally generated, which allowed for the lips to be synced to any language. Cooper first learned of this when his French-Canadian colleagues at BioWare got their hands on the French version of the game. Alright guys, that's it for today's video. In the comment section below, tell me which fact you thought was the most interesting. Share your thoughts in the comment section below. If you enjoy the video, remember to hit that like button and subscribe for more commentaries like this. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you next time.